hope for a future where women are free, where women are safe, where women are respected.
We must be ready, wherever and whoever we are, to respectfully disrupt any misogynist behavior that demeans anyone.
To me, being respectfully disruptive means speaking up when you see behaviors that hold back the progress that we're all trying to make.
The more women you have in the higher positions, the less the pay gap. And you have to be willing to really push that and be respectfully disruptive. And sometimes that's very unfamiliar and sometimes very uncomfortable. But that's what you have to do to make progress.
I would like to say just to listen to those who dare disrupt.
We need to move away from talking about these are the numbers. We need to talk about how do we fix it.
We need to make sure that we remove all the unconscious biases. We need to level the playing field. We really need to create an inclusive environment and look at talent as a talent, regardless of their gender.
Generative artificial intelligence doesn't just replicate stereotypes or disparities that you see in the real world. It actually exacerbates these and makes them appear much worse.
When you launch products and services, you have a responsibility to understand how those products and services interact with society, including societal norms.
Understanding legacy systems so that when we're adopting different solutions or we're talking about what's coming next, we are actively checking the systems that are still in use.
The sexes have to and will rise and fall together.
We have to make men, young men especially, feel like gender equality, gender equity, and feminism are also things that are for them. Because if young men feel like we're not working for them, we're not speaking for them, they'll go find someone who they think is. If not us, who?
If not now, when, right? Thank you and have a great rest of your 78th Angat.